ओम नमः शिवाय माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट जंप स्टेटमेंट। जंप स्टेटमेंट देयर आर टू टाइप्स, फर्स्ट वन इज़ अ ब्रेक एंड सेकेंड वन इज़ अ कंटिन्यू। सो ब्रेक स्टेटमेंट एनेबल्स अ प्रोग्राम टू स्किप ओवर अ पार्ट ऑफ द कोड। अ ब्रेक स्टेटमेंट टर्मिनेट द वेरी लूप इट लाइज विद इन। एक्सिक्यूशन रिजूम एट द स्टेटमेंट इमीडिएटली फॉलोइंग द बॉडी ऑफ द टर्मिनेट स्टेटमेंट। सो this break statement is used as a jump statement, and this statement is used to terminate from loops, and it is used basically to come out from the loop basically. So here there are some statement that this is basically a syntax, obviously while loop and for loop. So here you can see that is while loop text condition is there and for loop variable is there in some sequence. So statement 1 will be executed first. Next there is a condition using the if statement. So after that there is a break statement, and next there is statement 2, 3 and statement 4, 5. So when there is a break statement in while loop or for loop, so then the loop will be, the executions will be come out from the loop and it will be not execute statement 2 and statement 3, and it will be execute statement 4 and 5 because there is a break statement. Now there is a one code, small code is there, that is we define a b c equals to 0. Next it is using a for loop, a in range 1 comma 21, that's mean it will be start from 1 and it will be continue up to 20. Okay, so next we take one value, two value from the user using, and we store the value into a and b variable respectively. We give the statement to the user, that is enter number 1, enter number 2. Now we check that if b equals to 0, next we print this line and we break, and we use the break statement at here, and in else pass we just divide the number and we show the results. And this statement is the outside of the loop statement. So inside of the loop statement, the loop body is this one. These are the loop body. Okay. So suppose user give at here, enter first number, user give at here 10. Okay. Enter second number, user give at here 5, suppose. So it will be checked, that is if b equals to 0, that's mean it will be checked, that is 5. equals to 0, so it's not, so it will be come to else part, it made a division and it will show the result. Next again the controller go back to the for loop. For the next time again it's check another number, suppose again it's check user give right now suppose 20 and b suppose 0, so it's 0. So when there are condition, that is if b equals to 0, the condition is satisfied, then this line will be print, and next line, that is a break statement, so the controller will come out from this loop, from this for loop, and it will be print this statement, that is print program over. Okay, so that's it here. Same types of output is there. When user is given second number as 0, it will be divide, it will be show that is a division of the 0 is occurred, and it will totally come out from the loop, and the last line program over is printed. Next there is another program, this is the most this is a very interesting kind of program, that is you want a number from user and you check that number, and you basically you say to guess a number. If user gives proper number, then you can show that is you win, otherwise you can say that is try again, or your guessing number is wrong, like this way. So for this one we are using the random function at here. Basically we use the random function using this random module. In the random module there is a random function. The details of the module that will be I will explain you in the next class of 12. I say you that random is a module, and module which contain different type of functions. Among all the function, randint is one function, and within this randint function there is a lower limit and upper limit. So in the lower limit you can define a number from where you want to increase, and upper limit is also there where we can bind the limit. So here you can define, here the code is there, that is rand int 10,50. That's mean you can take any rand number randomly, and we store the number into that's number variable. Basically, rand int function is used to take or to basically we it is used to take any random number from this given sequence. So to execute or to select or to take any kinds of random number, you can use this randint function. Okay, next CTR, one variable is defined here. Next we define CTR less than 5. That's mean the program will be executed, that's or the this loop will be executed, basically not program, this loop will be executed 5 times. Now you say the user to guess a number from 10 to 15. Whatever the number user will be guessed, that value will be stored into this guess variable. Now we check the if guess equals to number. So this number is come from here, and this number is basically randomly selected. Computer, that's mean the compiler, randomly select any number from 10 to 15, and if that number is matched with the user's number, whatever the number is given by the user, then you can say that you win. And there is a break statement when it's print, that is you win, you just come out from the loop. Okay. So the next condition is that is a continue state. Next jump statement is a continue statement. Continue statement is another jump statement like break statement, as both the statements skip over a part of the code, but continue statement is somewhat different from break statement. Instead of forcing terminations, the continue statement force the next iteration of the loop to take place and skipping any code in between. So basically continuous statement is used to skip, is basically say the controller to skip the next part of the programs and go to the next iteration, and your break statement is used to come out or totally terminate your while or for loop coding. There is one small program is this one. So this program you can easily understand that is what is the difference between break and continue. So look at the code. Here we take one value from the user, basically print the loop with break statement as output. So first this line will be printed. So if we look at the output, this is your output portion. Write this program also in your computer lab copy. Okay, so in the output portion this line will be print first, because this is your first print statement. Next, for I in range 1,11 means it will be start from 1, it will 2, 3, 4, it will be continue up to 10. So next, if I modulus 3 equals to 0, that's mean here we divide the number of I by 3 and we check the remainder is 0 or not. So that's why we use the modular sign at here. So if I, that's mean for the first value is 1, so 1 modulus 3 equals to equal to 0, it is not, so it's print I, that's mean it will be print 1. Next, the I value, after that again the controller will go back to the for loop, and the next value of I is 2 right now. So 2 modulus 3 equals to equal to 0, so it's not, so it will be print, that is it will come to the else part and it will be print I. So I means 2, so this 2 will be print. Next, again the controller go back to the sequence, and right now I will become 3. Now it's check that if I modulus 3 equals to equal to 0, yes, for right now 3 modulus 3 equals to equal to 0. So next there is a break statement. Okay, so when there is a break statement, so the compiler totally terminate this code of the for loop, and it will be go to the next step of the for loop. That's mean this print the loop with continue procedure. So this line the loop will continue produce output as this will be printed here. Next, there is another for loop is there. So for I in range 1,11, that's mean again this type of range it will be create 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10. Next is same line is that, see the coding are the same, just in the place of break we write the continuous, so we can understand the proper difference. So here I, that's mean 1 modulus equals equals 0, no, so it will be print I, that's mean print 1. Next it will be go back to the for loop. Next I value it became 2, so 2 modulus equals equals 0, no, it will be print I, so print 2. Next I became 3, and it check that 3 modulus equals equals 0, yes, this one, so it will be come to the if part. In the if part there is a continuous statement, and continue is used to use to just skip that iteration, and it will be go to the next iteration. So that's mean it will be skip this part, all the whatever the line, if suppose there is other sign also, it will be skip that thing, and the iteration will go to the for the next value, and the next value of the I, it will be it is 4, so it will be again check that 4 modulus equals equals 0, no, it will be print I. So that's mean after 2 the 4 value will be print. In the same way 5 will also be print. Next 6, when I will become 6, 6 modulus 3 equals equals to 0, so for this one continue just skip that part for I equals to 6, and it will be go to the next part where I equals to 7, and it will be print that value 7 8. Again 9 it will be skip, it will be print, and fine, and next last value that is 10, so it will be print for 10 also. So now the difference is that when the break statement is there, so it will be totally come out from your loop, and when the continuous statement is there, it's just skip your that particular iteration, and it's go to the next iterations. Okay, so I hope all of you understand today's class. Om Namah Shivaya students.